Hello, I'm Kavita Kane and I recommend for E-Time Books. I'm an author of 6 novels right behind you. I'm saying them in a chronological order. Kanda's Wife, Sita's Sister, Menka's Choice, Lanka's Princess, The Vishukuni Dynasty and the latest, Ahilya's Awakening. I hope I don't sound too vain, but yes, I do recommend these books too. In these times of when we say we have a lot of time in our hands, and actually we realize we really don't, because this is the time I have rediscovered my family, my home, my house actually as a physical structure, where I realize after the cleaning and the chores, when you realize each furniture piece and sort of cleaning the bookshelves and cooking up a special dish, all these things, when you it's not only rediscovering different corners and niches of your own house, it's rediscovering corners and niches of your own self. So I think this is the perfect time to do so. For books, I think coming back to the point of topic of books, while I was cleaning my shelves, my bookshelf, I realized I have this bad habit of rereading the books then cleaning the shelves. So what should take just about, let's say, 2 hours, I end up spending a whole day browsing and perusing through the books and actually sitting down and reading pages of it. So in that I found this book, which is, I know it's yellow old, wherein it cost $3. My favorite author, Somerset Maugham's The Razor's Edge. And yes, I'm sure most of you must have read it, but I think here I'm talking about rereading them. This whole beautiful experience of going back to a book, the art of rereading, the art of finding yourself, the art of finding the book, rediscovering the book, finding its layered meaning, and finding the change perspective. That is so very important, because what you read, let's say 10 years ago or 15 years ago, seems so very different now. The book has changed and so have you. So I think please do, I will definitely recommend going back to your own library, rereading your own book, the books which you already have, and rediscovering them. It's a lovely experience. It's, of course, there's a lot of nostalgia, but more than that, I think it's the whole thing of that entire process of rereading, you know, revisiting, reinterpreting the whole book. I think that's something very unique. Fresh books, yes. I usually pick up books written by my co-panelist at LitFest, and one of them was this, The Living Hell by Vivaan Shah. The moment I read it, I read the first 3 pages, and it immediately reminded me of Raymond Chandler. I told Vivaan so, and he was delighted. He said, yes, in fact, it's a tribute to Raymond Chandler. And yes, if you are a Raymond Chandler fan, please do read this book. If you are not a Raymond Chandler fan, still do. I insist on you all reading this book, because it shows Mumbai in such a different light. Mumbai is a huge character in this book. It talks about how, for an everyday man, things can suddenly change. You know, what you don't know what is happening in the next door. You're staying in a flat, you don't know what is happening next door, and suddenly the world turns upside down. So yes, do read this book, and please let the author know that you have liked it. I love short stories. Because I think this is a genre which is so sadly neglected nowadays. But we grew up on a lot of short stories, when I found this book, what I found amazing about it, that yes, it's a Runaway by Alice Munro. It's a winner of the Man Booker International Prize. She herself is a Nobel laureate, and it's a collection of stories about human emotions, of course, human experiences, and most importantly, relationship, the power of relationship, and even the relationship you have with yourself. And I think that is one of the most powerful drive in your life, which we often don't realize it, and how each of these female characters overcome. And I think that is what we need to do. We are going to overcome these times, and I think we have the power and the patience and the persistence to do so. So I think let's keep up that spirit and read. And talking more about reading, this was one book which I liked it because I picked it up because I loved her first book, The Girl on the Train. The second one is Into the Water by Paula Hawkins, and I was intrigued more as a writer with about this book because it has 11 separate narratives with different character tones, and I find it absolutely amazing that how she could insert 11 character narratives out here, because writing 2 and 3 itself is challenging enough. Weaving 11 of them and in an episodic manner, and more than just 11 narratives, it is also the different 11 perspective, the looking at things at a particular incident, at a certain violent incident which happens in the village, and the reaction. So it's a grimly gripping, it's a psychological thriller, and yes, please do read this, because I think it is different. It's different. It might be a little confusing because, as I said, it has 11 characters telling their version of the incident. But that actually even shows, keeps the sort of the reader in on his toes. You know, you have to be very careful. So please, that's the only spoiler I'll give. Please do not get confused and muddled. Read it with this perspective that there are 11 characters going to tell the story. And these two books, I must confess, I stole from my daughter's collection because they are hugely into non-fiction. One is this, Dara Shikho by Avik Chandra, and the other is Vikram Sampath Savarkar. Both very, as they say, both, I think I should not talk much about these books because they are self-explanatory. Dara Shikho is about, of course, Aurangzeb's older brother. He was the crown prince, and it beautifully, and what I liked about both these books is how it is, and I confess again that I'm not I'm more into fiction than non-fiction, so how non-fiction, when you use the whole concept of storytelling, when how non-fiction is told, retold as a story, and this whole art and the narrative of storytelling is it's very 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 rampant in these two books, and I love them. Savarkar really took a longer time because it's a tome and it's only part one of the part two, which is supposed to be coming out, I think, this year, next year, really. So two non-fiction and the others are all fiction. I hope I've covered all the genres. Yes, happy reading, happy quarantine, stay calm, stay safe, and importantly, stay home.